Hi everybody, I hope you're having a great day. In this video, I'm going to be covering Aquaman. He made his very first appearance in More Fun Comics, issue number 73, in November of 1941. But his current version debuted in Aquaman volume 7, issue number 1, in November of 2011. His most commonly accepted real name and origin are as Arthur Curry, but he's also gone by the Atlantean name Orin. Aquaman stands 6 feet 1 inch tall and weighs 325 pounds, having blue eyes and blonde hair. He's one of the strongest of the Atlanteans, and his unique physiology gives him considerable superhuman strength, being on par with beings like Wonder Woman, as well as having advanced reflexes, stamina, and durability, being extremely resistant to high pressures, energy, and heat. He's extremely fast underwater and can breathe underwater as well. He also has the trademark ability to telepathically control other marine life. Although this ability is more akin to creating desires within certain animals versus directly controlling their thoughts and actions. He also wields a powerful weapon known as the Trident of Poseidon, which increases his ability to control the oceans and weather, and it can also create solid objects, project force fields, and transform into a sword. In addition to this, he's had a period where one of his hands was replaced with various devices. It went from being a cybernetic harpoon to a shape-shifting golden hand, and it even becoming a hand made of mystical living water. This being said, though, it's now been restored to his natural hand. Now, Aquaman was raised by lighthouse keeper Tom Curry after his Atlantean mother, Atlanta, returned to the ocean. He was raised in the small coastal town of Amnesty Bay, located in Maine of the United States. But as he aged, he eventually answered the calling of his royal destiny to be the ruler of a kingdom that covers nearly 70% of the earth. As the king of Atlantis, he was designated as the guardian of the oceans by Poseidon, and also became a founding member of the Justice League. He ended up marrying the powerful aquatic princess of Zebel named Mira, and spent many years trying to balance his commitment to Atlantis with his soft spot for the land dwellers. Eventually, after being disillusioned with the life of a superhero and after being mocked by the public, Aquaman abandoned both the Justice League and the throne of Atlantis for a quiet life in Boston with his wife Mira. But after vicious aquatic beings attacked a small town near his childhood home, he and his wife tracked them down to the Marianas Trench. There they found a dying alien race that hunted surface creatures in order to stay alive. To put a stop to this barbarism, Aquaman buried them all with a seafloor volcanic explosion. The two of them then went on to find an Atlantean artifact that appeared to have a clue about the destruction of Atlantis. And while he was consulting with Dr. Shen about it, he got the alert that one of his old nemesis named Black Manta was hunting the Others, which was a team that Aquaman had put together to protect the known ancient Atlantean artifacts. Black Manta had taken some of the artifacts, including a scepter that belonged to Atlantis' ancient ruler, known only as the Dead King. And when Black Manta headed towards the Dead King's tomb in Antarctica, Aquaman and his others were right on his tail. They intercepted the Black Manta and beat him, but an unknown person had seized the scepter and used it to release the trench creatures again. Around this time, Aquaman's brother named Orm had started a war with the surface dwellers when a military test accidentally threatened Atlantis. Aquaman also learned that an Atlantean named Volko had been the one to betray him and steal the scepter, and that he had actually awakened the Dead King. There was a mess going on. The Dead King attacked the surface world with snow and froze the undersea kingdom of Zebel with Mera inside. Simultaneously, one of Aquaman's old foes named Scavenger was attacking Atlantis. Aquaman first freed his wife Mera, and then they repelled the Scavenger. But at this time, the Dead King had taken possession of his trident and told him that his family were not true royals, but had stolen the throne. To Aquaman's shame, he learned that his ancestor was the Dead King's brother, who had murdered the rest of his family. In revenge for this, the Dead King had created the relics and used the scepter to sink Atlantis. In the ensuing confusion, Aquaman found the scepter in a shipwreck below him, and he then tapped into its powers to lead the vicious trench beings in an attack against the Dead King. After they barely defeated this foe, Aquaman made the decision to destroy this weapon, and he also became King of Atlantis once again. But it's unfortunate that in the wake of a peace agreement between Atlantis and the surface, Aquaman's brother Orm could not let it go. Aquaman has gone on to have many adventures, engaging in battle with Chimera, Atuma, and even the Swamp Thing. One thing that's never changed, though, is that he's always been the noble king, member of the Justice League. Now, for his powers and abilities, and his influence on the DC universe, For my 1 to 10 rating, I'll give Aquaman a rating of 10, which is a legendary rating. I hope everyone enjoyed this video. I'll talk to you next time. Be sure to like and subscribe to The New Sage.